Hello, everybody on YouTube. This is Super Nintendo, and welcome back to another episode of The Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time Master Quest. In the last episode, we did the first half of the Spirit Temple. This time, we're going to hopefully finish the Spirit Temple. So, let's move on. First things first, since we now have the silver gauntlets, let's go up here. And push you out of the way. Whoops, I let go of the button. I didn't mean to do that. I'm a terrible game player. Or am I? Okay, I don't even know how I don't even remember how to get past this. Don't remember. Hopefully my memory comes back on shit like that, but for now, let's see if we can go forward like this. Unless there is a little button. I do not think so. I do not see one. Okay. Ha! You thought you could defeat me by transforming into a monster? Wrong thing. I think that is supposed to be the Scarecrow song. You know, I'm pretty sure, Link, you shouldn't be able to be holding the ocarina in the manner that you are. Excuse me? Ah! Floor Master! And I wonder if the mini Floor Masters are actually called something different. Well, let's use the hover boots. Whoa. So now there is a treasure chest behind some boxes. And if there's one thing, Legend... Let go of me! Nope! Killed all of them. Alright. I didn't know there was a wall master, floor, ceiling master, whatever the fuck these things are called, in this room. I think this one actually kind of saved me earlier, so I will honor it by murdering it. Because that's what heroes do. Heroes kill things. they kill them. I don't know what the fuck I'm talking about. I do not know what je fuck we talking about. Alright. Fire arrow you. Fire arrow you. I think there's another one over here I need to fire arrow. There we go. And let's hook shot up here. Hopefully those torches stay lit. Oh, now you fucking inform me that these things, oh, hello. Welcome to soup. Fuck you too, game. You know, fighting these things is a lot harder when I also have to worry about a giant hand coming up from the ceiling, or coming down from the ceiling. I need to learn my cardinal directions. You know, trying to whisk me off into death. Or, well, not to death, really, but... Come on. I think there's a reason why these things have barely showed up in 3D Zelda. Because they're very annoying. I have murdered your hand, and as such, down here and activate that treasure chest. Hopefully I don't die. I didn't want magic. I wanted health of some kind. Preferably of the kind that involves pots. Oh. Hooray. Hooray. Hooray, I have committed murder of the spider variety. Okay, so that was the reason. Okay. Nice to know that by causing a weird... Okay. That treasure chest makes no goddamn sense. We in the future are activating a switch that causes a treasure chest to appear in the future. Like, we activate that switch in the future, but we collect the item in the past 7 years before we activated the switch that caused that thing to appear. That makes no sense. Like, a temporal causality loop is one thing, but that makes no goddamn sense. Whatever, I'll be right back as a adult. Now we got multiple BMOs. N64 GameCube version is a lot more finicky with the hitboxes on those damn things. As I've noticed, because sometimes I throw a bomb at them and they explode, and other times they do not. I think after this week of recording, I think I need to take a little bit of a break from recording because murder on my back to sit in this chair. This puzzle, sort of. If I remember correctly, I want to teleport that one over there. Then, play the song over here twice. Because when that first block of time teleports back up to the ceiling, then the box will fall through it and land on the bottom block. And that was boxing with Babish. Don't box with him. He has a mean right hook, and if he gets you with it, you won't be able to eat his food. I've been watching a lot of binging with Babish lately, so it's, Dinolphos. Is this the first Dinolphos we've seen? I don't know if we ever saw any of them before. They're basically stronger Lazalfos. Okay. Didn't mean to do that, but... Oh, hello. Hello, invisible douchebag. Okay. This is gonna be where things get tough. At least I know that bombs hurt these things, so I can just keep tossing bombs at them. Yep, now you're a lady. I'll make a woman out of you by forcing you to ingest my bombs. My round things that go boom. You did not ingest my round thingy that went boom. I am very disappointed in you. You do not want me to be disappointed, because when I get disappointed, things go boom. When I get disappointed, Mr. Bigglesworth gets upset. And when Mr. Bigglesworth gets upset, people die! I really like how the mirror shield looks when you first get it. I like this very crystalline thing that it has before you actually like use it. But I don't know. Stab you in the butt, I will stab you in the crotch, and I will stab you in your nose. I will stab you all kinds of places. Man, these guys are a lot more tricky than the... I don't know if we have seen a Dinophos before this point. Because I don't know if they were even in the base game. Please don't be a trap. Damn it! Thing has become creepy as fuck, which means it's time to move the block back to its original position. Hello, Mr. Gibdo. I'm from the Fire Nation. I bring you many great foods, such as flaming fire flakes. Which I also saw Binging with Babish make, because... Nope. Nope. Okay. Now that we have that. Now that we have the mirror shield, we should be able to make a bit more progress. Because now... over here... wrong song. Accidentally pressed the A button instead of the button. What? Oh, for fuck's sake, I have to kill these guys again?
All three of you were phonies. You were great big phonies.
Ow.
All three of you were phonies. You were great big phonies.
Excuse me? Excuse me, I touched that silver rupee. You shall give it to me. Getting all those, we do get, a small key for our troubles, but now we have to make our way all the way back the long way, so I will see you guys in a minute. Okay, good. These things are not appearing again, which is very, very good. I do not want to fight them again. Because violence is not the way of my people. The people of Super Nutendia. Hmm. believers! You swine! I will murder you all! I will murder you all! You must all die! All must be murdered. There. You think that'll stop me? I've killed far worse than you. I've killed armies! Armies of monsters! Are these things just infinitely respawning? Is me being down here not doing much of anything? Oh, a purple lever. Yeah, I can kind of talk about this, I guess. Okay, cool. But, basically, there are certain enemies that killing enough of them will cause a giant version of them to appear. These giant versions are not, any stronger than the bigger, than the smaller versions, but, like, they're just kind of... I saw that. I saw the gold skulltula. You can't fool me. You cannot avert your eyes. You cannot just come in here, come into my house, and... What the hell? Oh, I thought that was a rock golem. I thought that was a rock golem for a second. It was like, was there an enemy that was completely unique? But no. Well, joke's on you, Moblin, which I believe is what you are. I have ranged weapons this time. Okay. Kind of weird to see the boulders just go from side to side like that. That sun is just sitting there smiling menacingly. I don't have Malon's song. Epona's song. I don't know if I need it for this. Do I need it for this? Ow! Yes, I think I do need it for this. I don't have Epona's song, so... I will be right back. I need to go get Epona's song. Oops. I didn't think that was mandatory for the Master Quest dungeons, but apparently it is, so I will be right back. Okay. Finally back. I have went and got the Epona's song. So we should be all ready to go. Although I don't know what's inside of that one. I don't know how exactly I would do that. Maybe Sun Song? That would make sense. Yeah, that's probably what it is. Like I said, I've done these dungeons before on the 3DS version, but I'm not entirely sure how much of the 3DS dungeon is, or the 3DS Master Quest is this. Just, you know. I don't know how much of the 3DS Master Quest is different from this, so it is kind of weird, because I haven't actually completed the GameCube N64 version of the Master Quest, you know, game before. I did the first dungeon before, and that was about it, because I just kind of assumed that, okay, why is... Song of Storms, maybe? I don't know. There's nothing above that. Was the solution. Okay. What about this one? Zelda's lullaby? Okay. Wow, that's a lot of Skulltula. Good thing that I'm not afraid of spiders, otherwise that would probably be a very disturbing image. And you're invisible. You shouldn't be able to reach all the way over here. Fuck you. Ha ha ha, you can't hit me. Okay, so it turns out this whole thing was just kind of a waste of time, aside from that gold Skulltula we found. Please be an invisible treasure chest, because... Yes, yes you are. You are backwards. Well, I did need a heart, so I am actually kind of glad I got that. There we go. Wait. Hold on a sec. Hold on a tick. Is that Vati? Is that thing supposed to be Vati? It It's a spherical eyeball thing with wings, possibly being a reference to wind. I've never noticed that before. I wonder if that is supposed to be a reference to Vati. That would be really fucking cool if it was. Okay, so now that we've got that, next up, we get hit by another Phantom Pot. Fuck you. I don't even need to kill you. But if that thing really is Vati, like, maybe that's a thing that's, like, retroactive, where they just, like, put a cool image or something, and then they created something based on that design later, but I don't think I've ever seen anybody talk about that, because I never noticed that thing. But then again, I'm also kind of an idiot, and I don't notice stuff all the time. And there is a fire keys! Excuse you! Very much like a heart. Okay. Let's see. Get out our bow and arrow. So we can snipe those guys out of the air. Good. Okay. I don't think we can latch onto these walls, can we? Yes, we can. We got that. Okay, fuck you too, game. You know what? I have something better than your stupid bullshit. I have intelligence. I have intelligence. And yes, I know I'm mispronouncing it. I don't care. In the normal dungeon, there was something over here, but there isn't in the master quest, so I guess we will go on ahead. We're missing a key. Vati, for those who don't know, is a villain who was later introduced in The Legend of Zelda Minish Cap. It is a very beloved Zelda game. I did play through it a couple of years ago. personally, I'm not a big fan of Minish Cap. I'm not a huge fan of that game. The story's fine. My problem mostly is just, like, mechanically. I'm not a big fan of it in that way. You know, like the... We got a green bubble here. Too bad for Bubbles. He was not hardcore enough. So, recently, recently I've noticed that, I have made several characters that, for one reason or another, actually do resemble, Bubbles. At least in terms of, you know, personality, there's quite a few things with Bubbles that, that these characters do actually... Invisible treasure chest. I think. Yes, I was correct. Invisible treasure chest! But, anyway. These characters that I ended up making, they actually do have a couple of similarities to Bubbles in the way that, one of the characters that I made, basically, they're one of those, type of fictional characters that basically, they perpetually just kind of look very young, very, they look like they're, like, 10-ish. Like, they look very, very young. Even though they're not actually supposed to be, like, super duper young. And, this character of mine actually, like, she is actually supposed to be, like, she has this problem of, like, she doesn't want to be treated as a child, and she doesn't want to... You know, she doesn't like people treating her like a kid, even though she is, even though, like, she's not, like, she isn't actually a kid, she's just one of those characters who is, like, she looks much younger than she actually is. And... Basically, her parents, have this, kind of the Dr. Doofenshmirtz thing with Vanessa, where, basically, they just kind of look at her and see a, they look at her and they just see their baby girl, essentially. And, because of that, Alright, the enemies are back, but that is okay. But, they basically just kind of see their baby girl. And, I think I killed two of those things with one shot. Future me, can you, like, play that back in, like, slow motion, zoom cam, something? Because I want to see if I actually did kill two of those things with one blow, because that was fucking cool. But anyway, they just kind of see their baby girl, and we got another iron knuckle here. Can I see inside your helmet, please? You saw an eyeball there for a sec. Okay. Oh! Can I break this? Or do I need to get this iron knuckle to break it? I think I need the iron knuckle to break it. Considering this thing can one-shot me, it's probably not a very good idea to incur its wrath. So, is that it? Nope, there's still at least one more. Whoa! Oh, there's another one over here. Okay. Iron Nucky? Iron Nucky? I'm over here. There doesn't appear to be one on the other side of this, so I think we're good. Alright, we got all the gold sculptulas. Let's get the fuck out of here. Ugh. How many bombs do I got? Naboru is going to be a challenge. Ah, no! Ooh, especially after that. Come on. Thank you. Looks like someone's here, Komi. Looks like it, Kotake. What an outrageous fellow he is to intrude so boldly into our temple. We should teach this outrageous fellow a lesson. Oh, loyal minion. Destroy this intruder on our behalf.
Forget you just saw that!
There we go.
well, looks like she's back to normal, Koumi. She's just a little girl, but she commands a lot of respect amongst the Gerudo Kotage. Maybe we should make her work for the Great Ganondorf for a little while longer. Then we should brainwash her again.
Kotake, you can laugh like that all you want, but you're not Dr. Ivo Eggman Robotnik.
Came to offer himself as a sacrifice to the Great Ganondorf. With my flame, I'll burn him to the bone! With my frost, I will freeze him to his soul.
If you can't tell, I have a lot of fun voicing these two. I think it's so much fun just voicing two just psycho old ladies. I'll come back to haunt you. I believe the 3DS version changed that to say that will come back to haunt you. But, yeah. So, to talk a little bit about the Gerudo. Specifically Noboru and, like, how they're designed in this game as opposed to in later games. I do kind of like their more Arabian style that they have here, where they're just kind of like normal human-looking characters who just happen to be like from the desert and whatnot. But at the same time, I do kind of like the greater sense of looks like she's about the same size as Link, if not just a little bit, you know, smaller. I don't understand why people get so pissed off at the realistic design in Twilight Princess when you got realistic shit like this with Rauru's face. Like, come on. But that'll do it for this episode. We have gotten every gold Skulltula that there is in all of the dungeons. So it turns out there's a little less than half. But finding six of them in the overworld really isn't that hard. You will likely find six of these things in the overworld just by playing through the game. And, like, I don't understand why people hate the Gold Skulltula as much as they do. Most of, like, almost half of them are in the dungeons. Because, keep in mind, although we are on Master Mode, or Master Quest, these 44 Gold Skulltula, they're in the normal mode too. The only difference between the Gold Skulltula in the dungeons in the Master Mode, or Master Quest, and in the normal mode is their locations. Like, their locations is different. How you get them is different. But they have the same number from the normal mode to the Master Mode. So, like, I don't understand why people hate them as much as they do. Because not only do you have a wide selection as far as which ones you can get, like in Mario 64, but also the fact that just going off of the ones in the dungeons, you get almost all the ones you need to get to the last reward that really matters. And you can get, by the time you get all the ones in the dungeons, you can get most of the ones in the game. But I suppose that will do it for this episode. Next time on The Legend of Zelda, Ocarina of Time, Master Quest, we're going to go to the Gerudo Training Ground. See you guys then. Let it all out. Let it all out. You don't have to think your heart is made of steel. Come away now from your own doubt. Like a flower of hope that's growing in a field, you will heal. Although the road has changed, you gotta carry on and show them you're strong. You gotta bury what is past and gone. Some days will be worse than others, but you gotta find another way. Yeah, yeah. Through pain and fear, our rain and tears, we will hold on to the light. We'll chase the dawn that waits for us beyond the dark sky. Keep following the distant star. Never walk away from who you are. Never forget that your future's waiting up ahead. Our seasons change and rearrange, and the sands of time descend. As all your hope starts vanishing, you'll always have a friend. Eaten by the snares of darkest night.